First tonight, a proposed EV battery plant near Big Rapids has become a polarizing issue for both those who are in favor of the new facility and those who are adamantly opposed. One person who has serious questions about the project is 2nd District Congressman John Molinar, who represents the area in Washington. He sat down today with political reporter Rick Albin and expressed concerns over the development.
There are some environmental concerns. Tell me about your take on this.
Sure. Well, one of the contributing factors is that there are a lot of non-disclosure agreements signed, and so it's been very difficult for residents to get accurate information about the project, and that's from state officials and others. Secondly, the Goshen High Tech is the parent company for Goshen Inc., and right in the Articles of Association, it talks about loyalty to the Communist Party and setting up a party organization and carrying out the activities and the duties of the party according to the Chinese Communist Party. So that is a legitimate concern, especially when you consider it's under 100 miles from Camp Grayling, where, according to the Wall Street Journal, we're actually training Taiwanese military leaders for a potential invasion by mainland China. So there are a host of concerns, but the Chinese Communist Party connection is probably looms the largest.
How do you quantify that? You talked about the non-disclosure agreements, but we have foreign companies doing business in the United States all over. How do you quantify the concerns because this happens to be a Chinese company?
Well, I think when you look at our strategy with respect to China, the last few decades has been constructive engagement. The idea that if we do business with them, we'll influence them, they'll become more like us, more freedom-loving, both for human rights, property rights. What we've seen is just the opposite. With Xi Jinping, he's put himself in charge of the military-civil fusion, which basically says any private sector business has an accountability and responsibility to the military and the Chinese Communist Party. And so it's really gone the other direction in terms of human rights, suppression of dissent. And so the question then is, how much more do we want to be relying on the Chinese Communist Party as a possible partner in any venture?
Goshen's vice president of North America Manufacturing said during a virtual town hall earlier this month that the Chinese Communist Party has no influence on North American operations. Last week, the legislature gave final approval to state incentives for that plant.